Team sequence, turn to pick.
Imbus spirit.
Turn to pick. E Holmes, turn to pick.
Night Stalker.
E Holmes, turn to ban. Team Secrets, turn to ban.
Hello, boys and girls. Welcome back to more Mars TV Dota 2 Winter League action. We are in the main stage right now as we're going to continue on forward into, what'd you say? Phase 3? Wave 3? You said Heat 3? Whatever I want to call it.
The third set.
It's the third stage. And, well, we are in the middle of Secret being one up against Ehome. And it looked like Ehome had potential. Strong pushing lineup, Lycan, Pugna. And one thing we didn't say that might have also been a huge drawback was that Aegis timing, man. That was so critical. They lost the Aegis. It seemed like they're almost dumbfounded. They didn't have the second life.
You can't completely blame it on that, though, because they continued on a push without it.
That's the thing. But then at that point, they're kind of like, do we keep going? Are we pulling back? What's happening? And by that point, Secret's like formulating a game plan. They're seeing ODs not coming back, and they took advantage of them. Mm-hmm. And I think ever since that point, maybe the small tilt factor, it never came to be. So, game two starting. Let's get in that freaking draft so we can see what the hell they're picking here. And it looks like Secret are going to be opening up with the precious Invoker Ember Spirit while Ehome snag up. Well, they're getting influenced by everyone else, it seems. They first picked themselves the Batrider and followed up with a Night Stalker. So, already talk about serious control coming out from Ehome here. Banned out of the way, Secret got rid of the Faceless Void. They themselves banned out the Earth Spirit and rid again of the Terrorblade. Ehome. They ban out the Chen, the magical puppy Chen. Ventral Spirit's got to go. Obvious good counter to the Batrider. They also take the effort to get rid of the Oracle. And, of course, a nod towards the Dazzle here. So a lot of support hate here coming out from Ehome. But the Batrider's almost in safe territory. What's left out there? Maybe a Shadow Demon to disrupt him seriously? But,
Slark.
Slark?
I don't think there'll be a Slark, though. It's already a different type of game, though. Ehome have committed to more map control in the lineup. Team Secret have not opted for a very first phase, very early first phase Oracle pick, and instead go for the Ember.
5 seconds remaining. I don't know. Do you think the Ember would have been banned going into the second phase of picks? I feel like they maybe could have, you know, filled that spot with something a bit more valuable. But nonetheless, they do follow it up now with the Witch Doctor grab. Doesn't seem like a direct counter to anything here, but we know Witch Doctor would just be a hugely potent support. The proper cast timing, great Voodoo Restoration to go with their team. And yeah, assist with great lockdown.
I think they just wanted a safe laner that can fight early, yet isn't susceptible that much to Batrider. Although I guess Juggernaut would have been an option for them, but they've proven that they heavily favor the Ember Spirit over the Juggernaut for the split push potential.
The play is, as Batrider jumps in the last one on your team, you just throw out the Coconut and hope that the Batrider takes that Coconut back to his team.
No, they have stronger lanes this game. I highly doubt they'll let the Batrider get first blood in the lane again, because of Ember and Witch Doctor being much, much stronger than Oracle and Spectre. Mm-hmm. So that was a real big weak point in their strategy, because they allowed the Batrider to get a Blink Dagger before the Oracle hit level 6, well before, in fact.
Ooh, Lady Death Prophet coming out as the third grab here.
Okay, maybe they still do want to push. But Quaswex Invoker owns pushes badly.
But does he own a Death Prophet in the mid lane? What do you think about that matchup? I mean, Invoker highly touted as one of the best in the lane right now.
He can't CS amazingly, but I mean, he can get CS and probably do decently.
Cold Snap away that pesky Soul Siphon.
He gives Tornado. And then...
Get off my grill, lady.
Yeah. I don't see why not. 5 seconds remaining. Death Prophets have been in lane, but it's more if you have a big threat that can actually kill the Invoker. It's more about the supports, I think, rather than that matchup itself.
It should be more about the style, and they do Invoker, Quas, Exort, and then still get the Shadow Demon that's very good against Batrider, and then you have Sunstrike up with
Shadow Demon is too risky.
Well, it's very good against push too. Come on.
He's so versus push. I think you want to do it if you have like an anti-mage or a Spectre who actually synergizes well with the illusions, but it's far too risky. Just because his range isn't as good as Oracle's. at all.
The Mighty Watermelon comes out here for Secret. Very good against someone like a Batrider. Typically, we see a lot, you know, until Batrider grabs up a BKB, it's like you're almost... Until you, like, get your early Blink Dagger and before Tide gets his, you know, it's... You're not going to get a... Always a clean getaway here. So, later in the game, when Tidehunter gets his Blink, you're kind of forced to grab him. Otherwise, you just are at risk being quickly countered by a Ravage.
It's okay if you don't grab him. Like, it's only a problem if Tidehunter has Blink. If he has a Blink, then yeah, you have to grab him.
I mean, but... there's still a window where Bat's going to be able to do as he pleases. Especially if we see another performance we saw from 11. He got, what, like a 9-minute Blink Dagger? It did help that he got that early kill, but still... This guy will get a Blink in good time. There will be a period of time where Tidehunter won't be able to counter from him, but already these are kind of, you know, difficult lasso targets. I just don't foresee this being the easiest Batrider lasso setup kind of a game, but we'll have to see. They still have one more support to go for the side of Secret, so we'll have to see what it's gonna, the follow-up's going to be. Ben, for Ehome here, they need another support, I imagine, to roll along with this Night Stalker. Someone probably more designated to the lane where Knight wants to take
they
advantage
also
of the first Knight.
They also need a core that can push towers. Another one, I would say.
Are they Lone Druid players, you think? Is that good enough? Terrorblade's been
good.
Taken away.
Juggernaut, I think, is probably my pick. Though.
That's like, yeah, very great.
Juggernaut can kill Tidehunter.
The Lanham Lion.
Interesting.
Hard Lockdown versus Ember, terrible versus Tide, however. Actually, you can just mana drain him in lane. Why not?
Yeah, he's got the base damage. He's got some zone potential. It's very good. And like you said, it's a good answer in lockdown for Ember, especially if he's able to get a blink. Ember already will feel a lot less safe about pushing, farming outside lanes, at risk of being jumped, because it leads in with a jump from Lion, then you get a follow-up Night Stalker silence or a lasso, and... whatever it may be, and he ain't gonna be going nowhere. Lots of lockdown. This might even be like a Ember Lincoln slash BKB kind of a game. Morling ban, and oh, that's a support Naga.
Yeah, support.
I almost like at just the side of it, but it's support.
Support Naga is one of the best counters to Batrider, although not many teams have done it. But as we remember, Secret and EG were like the, you know, but the two that really wanted to propel Nagasarn into like a first phase ban against them, and for good reason. Nagasarn sleep is so super super strong. You can even get out the ghost from Death Prophet too.
Yeah. And Puppy, I imagine Puppy's gonna be playing this. Yeah, he plays a really good Naga. He typically plays. I mean, I got to see the guy's freaking, I believe his Dota buff. This guy fiends Naga. Typically has a core in his pub game, I mean, and we already know him to be a micro lord.
I think they also should have waited on the Slark pick too. Slark's also pretty poor versus Naga. I'm talking about a big team fight sort of situation. Slark can just pick off Naga very easily, but in a team fight situation, if you ult, she can just sleep, and then you can just tie a Ravage and just destroy them. Like, this high ground is... It seems like... I don't know. With the Slark pick, though, they don't actually want to commit and force the high ground as early as they did last game. Overlay, please.
Take me out of jail. Please. Brian, get back there. Take the overlay off. He's over here in the kitchen. If someone got over there and hit the button, thank you so much. Well, we're back in action now. We're going to get underway. We saw that it's early Sunstrike. Got to get that intel here. And away we go. As far as game tempo goes, though, is about the same here for Ehome. Better to get more done sooner than later. Well, at the first, you know, window while Bat gets his blink, and don't want to risk going late against this Ember Spirit. It's not as greedy.
It's not
Secret.
About the lineup. It's about play style. Ehome, that's how they play.
Go!
They pressure a lot in the 10 to 20 minutes. Probably more so than like any other team that I know, actually. And like threaten. Okay, if you have one bad, really bad push, we're gonna take like two towers and threaten high ground. They threaten high ground with, in very unusual positions. Well, not unusual anymore because people expect it, but unusual compared to other teams. So it's always on Ehome to pressure more, and they usually like you know, execute it pretty well. The only time it's different is when they have an anti-mage.
So based on what we've seen so far, because we got to see a good chunk of Ehome at Frankfurt, but that was a different time and a different meta, and this is a new one. Do you think the tools that are kind of in play now kind of complement their playstyle more, or is it less with 6.86? I mean, remember we got to see a lot of, well, a Ravage coming out here for Planum, but he's still going to get caught up. Sunstrike, got him! Beautifully done there. Weeha is going to set up the book for himself. Soul Siphon return here for the Naga, but Naga is going to be able to slither away from trouble, it looks like, and Misery is going to be the gatekeeper and keep him away from the pressure. Secret off to a hot start, and oh, speaking of hot, old 11 here dishing out some fire auto attacks onto the back end here of Mr. Envy. Can he get close enough? No, he's going to be going down. Oh, double kills for Secret right now. A hard commitment comes out from the bat, hoping to get that ember, and he will drop.
It's another one of those situations where, like, the safe lane player just has not had that much play with the team. You can tell the top two, they only committed three, whereas Secret were there as four and immediately picked out the Lion, who was left out by his lonesome, and Slark kind of arrived late. Maybe they could have got killed with a Spirit Siphon into a pounce, but they just not enough bodies there at the start.
I think they really want to bounce back here. Pounce will connect. They move in. They're waiting for the follow-up stun from Lanham here. They'll get it. But looking to interject is going to be Puppy, who gets a big Riptide off. They are going to be able to get the grab onto Tidehunter. And it looks like Nightstalker will be able to make it away in the back end of a Tango. But oh, big Riptide damage onto Lanham. But Lanham, confident and strong, stays, gets off, impale. And they might be able to also bring down Puppy. It looks like they will. And they even preserve the last hit. It looks like for the Nightstalker, Kaka going to be picking up that one. Sunstrike. Oh, it got him, but not enough to bring him down. Just enough regen coming in for Lanham. And
everyone died in neutrals.
And now we all will bow before the mighty centaur god who will bat us in the head. And Lanham's like, that looks fun. I'm going to do that too. Got him. 2-0 for the centaur here. Best record in the game.
That's a nice move by Ehome, though. Normally you don't go in on a level 1 tie like that, but they realize he picked Gush up at level 1. So it's easy, way easier to kill them.
Everybody died in the neutrals. Let's go. Well, that's great for Ehome, man. Because that looked like a catastrophic kind of a start there. But hey, they're scrappy. They're able to put it together. And well, Pi, it's a secret game after all.
They're a high risk, high reward team. That's why I like watching them play.
So the question I was alluding to earlier, and as maybe I have to hold out again, mid lane, a trade between the two is Puppy, very happy to hard commit, does not care about no Siphon, will be able to take him down. The return fire, though, is they get Wii on the backside. Now they move in, suddenly a wild Pilot Eye appears after the death, and now they're going to get a good Maledict, a good Ensnare. There's the forward right clicks, and there's the kill. Back and forth we go. This game, much more action-packed. I think we had maybe one kill by this point last time, when suddenly we have 8 kills before 3 minutes. Very nice. And I know you're talking about how you like Ehome as a team. They are more go, go, go. And regardless of the draft, they'll put together what they feel is necessary to get their job done. But do you think 6.86 complements their playstyle better or worse from before? You gotta remember they got like Queen of Pains and stuff that would be more proactive as fighting in the mid game. Well, Death Prophet might not be the same. What do you think?
It's more so whether or not they can adapt, and I think they've shown that they're a very versatile team, so I don't really think it hurts them at all or helps them. Oh, actually, I think it helps them because they're more versatile and there's more options available in this patch.
Mm-hmm.
So
here they are, fighting some more mid lane. Weeha does take the best route to make it away, but it doesn't really matter. There's just too many swarming on in. They get the stun.
Where is
he? Gets a cold snap, but Death Prophet's gonna swat him on down, and the old chicken will grab that one up. Ehome pull ahead now 5-4.
That was his best chance of survival. I like that movement from him.
Yeah. He definitely read the situation to go for the best option out, but didn't seem like he had the tools to kind of keep him back.
What was his skill build?
Does he not have Tornado? I was going to say, nor Tornado, I assume.
Ooh, or the greedy build, no X.
And after going down, he quickly disconnects. I'm not sure if he felt like maybe there was something wrong with the machinery, but looks like he will need a moment to
need
collect
to contain
himself.
Some of that rage.
He's like, again, I go down? Unbelievable. 1-2-2. But
I am not fit for the Super Saiyan hair.
Look at the CS again. I actually wanted to see who was at the top there. Slark. Slark getting a lot of the farm. We haven't really looked at his lane too much, but
it's tight stacking.
Iron Talon, eh? Everybody get Iron Talon.
Iron frickin' Talon.
Yeah, that's changed the game a lot.
For the better? Or...
It's more options, but it's you can still punish it pretty easily, I would say. You just need to play aggressively. Like, you know, if they jungle too much, Ehome will just take on their towers.
Similar like, you know, when someone has to commit to like a Midas, let's say, you want to punish the greed. I mean, Talon's gonna add a bit of armor to not much else.
Talon's not a big commitment though, so it's like not, it's more so the playstyle that it evokes. Which is AFK farming in the jungle and not fighting. But you know,
we'll see.
You gotta balance it well. That's the hard part about Iron Talon, is balancing out the fighting and the farming. Like we saw FY on the Night Stalker earlier today, who balanced out very well. But if you commit too hard, like in the pubs, then you would just lose. Because Dota is about fighting.
Alright, good contention from 11 here. Tried to go for the fourth stack.
And the value. He got his clarity on for a very long time. The efficiency. I like efficiency plays too.
Oh, we know. 11 still always just seems to find his way, man. He is about to be level 6. A little after 4 minutes. My goodness, it's a good lane. And again, Weehaw in trouble. Weehaw quick to try to punish him, but this time they have the response and they're going to be able to take on the Death Prophet, but that means that they can make a full commitment into this bottom lane, diving beyond the tower right now. They're going to go for Envy, and they're going to get him.
Stun.
And then the follow-up possibly coming out, they're going to also take down Pylite Eye. They will lose their Night Stalker in the end, but...
Where's my Centaur when I need him?
But Lanham is a Gunslinger. Could have been a killing spree for the Centaur, but he was not present for this fight, unfortunately. But a big successful push they're having for Ehome, I gotta say. Oh, bottom lane. Look at this. Puppy going to work right now. They are going to get the catch with a helpful cast bounce right there in 11. With the Maldic stun, continue to tick on through. They've lost the Naga, and 11 is going to drop there in the end.
Oof.
I wasn't sure what level that Maldic was. If it was
that was
enough,
really close. He almost had a stick
close.
Up.
It's only one.
That three charge stick would have saved them.
Did cost them their support Naga, but...
Okay, what's Fan going for? Is it going to be Shadowblade Rush? Is it going to be Midas in the Shadowblade? That's going to be a Blink.
His name is Fan. He plays Slark. It reminds me of Van from Elite Wolves, right?
He picks up.
He plays Slark
Shadow
a lot,
Blade,
too.
Right?
Yes, typically.
I think it's a Shadowblade game.
Is the Fan a fan of the Shadowblade, though? You think it is?
Meh, why not? I have Night Stalker. Just make him feel scared everywhere. Batrider, Slark.
Yep.
And Night Stalker. Ugh. Yeah.
Maybe later a blinking lion. Nowhere is safe. I like that.
Midas.
Is that what he's doing?
Yeah,
I see it.
I think so.
The greed.
Right.
Yeah, so Midas.
Ah. All right.
I mean, he's farming very well. It's like going to be a 6.5, 7 minute Midas. That's
I mean, 36 and 20. I mean, he's even flexing the denies here right now. Really taking it to misery.
Fan is good at farming.
Fan is a farmer. Hard time for Wii a little bit here. This isn't feeling like a powerful invoker so far, but I don't know. Also, the Death Prophet been a bit quiet here. Are we expecting either of them to maybe kind of, you know, step away from this mid lane and take it to the fight? We know Death Prophets typically have an underwhelming early exorcism here. Uh-oh. Looks like they got a good catch. I love that synergy. And Snare right for the Sunstrike. Not quite enough damage, but eventually they will be able to bring down the Batman and invoker.
There's no rush for them. Because the Batrider is farming, okay, he'll get his blink at a decent rate at this pace, and then Slark has a Midas, so they're farming like very, very fine. So they can exert better map control. They don't necessarily want a team fight because a lot of their stuff gets countered ravaged into Naga Siren. So ideally, they want to take some engagements around their map, fight around Lasso, use Night Stalker vision to its fullest, and take it that way. It's again much different than last game where four to pressure early.
All right, are we seeing another on the move? We got some nighttime left.
Well, not going to work.
She's been all over the place, so she's 4.
But she's been involved in a lot of kills. 7,
yeah,
to be exact.
Not really finding a lot of me time here for Puppy to farm up, and it looks like they're continuing their expedition, this time to the bottom lane. Maybe anticipating the 11 Blink Dagger is going to be coming any moment, and they would not like that. So maybe if we could put him in his place, it would prolong our timing. And he's already committed the fight here. He's burning it down. Puppy is sweeping in the ensnare. It will swing. It will catch. I look at fall for the casket and go ahead and get the Sunstrike. Hey, Mission
How do you
accomplish?
I'm most surprised he had vision for the net.
I mean, did he have? It looked like he started with vision. It's just ensnares like one of those like, hold on a second while I stretch my arms all the way back. Shoot!
It's nighttime though, and I don't know if he was close to a creep or what, but they didn't have a ward down there.
Guess Puppy with just a brief sight had enough time to quickly get it off. But
so what he's going for? Mech Rush? Tranquil? Not sure. Looks like Mech Rush. And is he for BOTs? Seems that way. And Invoker going for Midas. Okay.
Do you at least get the arcane though before the mech on the Tidehunter? Otherwise, aren't you gonna run into serious mana problems?
Almost always, but
so
he likely just wanted it for the lane because you don't really need arcanes to jump.
Yeah.
Get it down quick. The next deck's coming.
All right.
Huh? Nearly 800 gold. He's on the way, and 11 is. Like, I really need to just get this blink
dagger. Is he gonna be able to stack this? It's a tough stack because Naga was kind of in it.
Yep. Yeah.
Looks good.
Three stacks.
Ready to go. Oh, speaking of stacks, Squirt's got their own mighty stack in right now.
They need to take it out, though, I think, like, before nighttime, or else, like, Eho might be up in their group.
That's a nod to Puppy multitasking. Looked like he stacked it with a illusion and then also scouted with another illusion to block out or scout out a stack, so. He's putting those illusions to hard work. 11's going to be burning down those creeps. He's again up to 200 gold away from finishing out that blink, and a Midas pick up here for Wii. Get him back on the path right now of recovery farm. It's been still, would you say, a relatively quiet game for Death Prophet on the other side, or is it still just not her win yet? It's only level 1 exorcism, level 8.
They don't have a lineup that pushes well. Aside from her, so she's just kind of there.
So what's her job then in this game? Like,
get farm, silence people.
She can't solo push tower. She'll get destroyed.
Yeah.
She'll get like easily mowed down by the ember. She can't get up and like up close and personal because of Tidehunter too. So like, there's a lot of stuff that
snare from downtown, follow up Sunstrike, even a Ravage committed all in here for the Night Stalker. Secret want this kill because it seems like they want something else on top of it, if anything.
Not even actually that important of a kill. It's a nice target during daytime, and it was a Ravage Blown, so I actually think it's a good opportunity for them to catch people out because they'll have the blink on Predator. Is he actually going mid right now with a smoke? Oh, so he's going mid without a smoke. They really want him, but it's tough during daytime.
He might get spotted out from Nagoshin's here.
Yeah.
And then the blink would be exposed. That would not be bueno here for Eho.
Okay, they get a big tower though. Wait, off the back of that kill. I'm surprising that Eho didn't fight that. What do you use exorcism on? Oh, she just used it. Okay, so just take us
on that tower. Doesn't seem like there's going to be much of a response to stop her from getting it, so that's a good grab for her.
Oh, wait.
Or maybe not. Suddenly a wild pilot eye appears, gets the Malig off at the ward, and old chicken wants to go toe-to-toe with the Soul Siphon Man. He just wrecks the Witch Doctor. Drops one to Misery. Misery has to turn away, and he just pilot eye learned a hard lesson right there. Death Prophet hurts.
Baited out 4 TPs. Guys pushed up.
Yeah, that's great. I mean, Secret before that, of course, committing a lot to take the Night Stalker, got them that tier 1 top lane. It doesn't look like he used much to get down extra wards. They have one extra ward up there, but they were able to respond. They get their own kill and tower in the bottom lane, so. And force out all those TPs. Ehome gotta be feeling pretty good.
They need to make sure that the Batrider doesn't die on bottom, though, so they don't lose this tower, too. Okay, nighttime. Woohoo!
Got nighttime, you got a Night Stalker, you got a Slark who can seek well in night, you got a Batrider with a blink and a lasso. This is Ehome.
Uh-oh. Double damage Ember Spirit, though. This could be a bad time. Night Stalker looking like a prime target.
What is the Ember guy? Is he going right for the Boots of Travel, by the way?
He got a Keela. Yeah.
Okay, looks like bots are going to be coming, though. Oh? Oh, bottom lane. Bats seeing if he can get a kill here without having to commit the lasso. It does force out the sleep. Is he going to blink and try to catch up with Misery here with a flame break, maybe? He's pursuing.
Nope, no flame break.
Oh, no. Okay, one's dead. We'll get the grab on the puppy. Pull him back, and I think Secret might have to let their captain fall here. Or not. Misery looking to re-engage. Naga does
go
down.
Yeah, he's going to get fingered, though, if he goes too close. Like, carry or Crypt Swarm in a finger, he's dead, so yeah. He can't go in.
I'm surprised Puppy got caught out there. I thought he was good. He could have just ran back with the tank, but it looks like he stayed around waiting for his team to come in. But Ehome were, in fact, the ones with the larger numbers. So, okay, so what is Slark on for? He's been super quiet this game.
Well, he got that Midas, and now he's got a lot of money. So,
like
Shadow Blade? Yeah.
Three gold.
Straight
gold.
Shadow Blade. Looks like trouble's creeping across the river. Ehome will eventually find themselves towards top lane. They're looking to make engagement onto Envy. They got to know he's banking up some serious money here.
This is a good time.
Ooh. You guys, bots. As the Shadowblade came online, and they found a wild Weeha. Lead in, Hex, stun. Here's there, but not necessary. Neither is the lasso. Okay, finally he's like, okay, he healed up. Let's just finger him out. Weeha will be dropped, but look at this. They're going to get a response. Nice Ravage from Misery will intercept. They get the grab onto 11 as Lana's also on the way out. But here comes Death Prophet committing the exorcism, right? Can Old Chicken make it dark? And he goes right into a silence and right into trouble. All that exorcism damage plus the siphon. And Ember doesn't stand a chance. Boots travel great for momentum and moving around, but not great for keeping you alive, unfortunately.
Yikes, second Ravage blown. And they didn't even kill the Batrider
in that engagement. But see, they never undercommit to a fight, though. Like in the bottom fight, when they got slept, they had everyone there in case they decided to turn around. And then that fight too, they three-man smoke, and everyone still followed up after that to make sure that the fight went okay for them. So you know, this is Ehome, like, they commit fully to each and everything that they do, which is very cool.
I'm sure that was very difficult for Secret to try to fight into. You gotta, it was darkness after all. And I'm sure they were stuck.
Darkness, exorcism.
Yeah, it's like you're, and look at all that search shop area, amongst all the trees. They can't see anything that's happening in there. Around their corner, just suddenly a new hero pops up, and they're like, oh my god, all the Ehome are here. And then there's exorcism flying through. That was a tough time for Secret, and I think we're hoping there was going to be a lot less, but the full Ehome family was there ready to play, and now Ehome up and ahead 12-10, recovery time right now. Misery rushing for the rest of his mech and a hopeful blink maybe as a follow-up. There's stacks to farm right here. Ehome have spotted him, it looks like. They're pinging it about, and they have the vision.
You know, this is one of the worst feelings as a support when you're super poor, and then you're playing against a Slark who has
Shadowblade. Yeah, nowhere is safe.
Such a terrible
You
thing.
Have to, like, buddy-buddy up. Like, hey, you mind if I just kind of follow you around for a while?
Not only that, you just have to buy a ton of sentries.
Oh. Condolences to Envy. He goes down. It looks like a good pickup between both Lanham and Slark.
Still have a tiny bit left on the daytime.
While they're making a go in top lane, Old Lemon's like, you guys move in. I found myself a little pile of die here. They're going to get the kill on that. And they can't even get the Death Prophet down. She's like, bring it on, baby. You don't got the Witch Doctor. Moves forward with a Soul Siphon, but now it might be too much. Puppy moves in. Eyes bigger than stomach, unfortunately, at that moment there for the Death Prophet. She will go down, but it's a 2-for-1 trade. That's the better for Eve right now. And Slark has been just farming away at this bottom lane after
completing.
Yeah, I was gonna say after the Shadowblade, he nearly has 2k gold. It looks like he's gonna be building right away for the Scotty, and then this Slark is gonna be a Goliath.
That is a successful night time, and now they know that Orr's there too. If he pinks it out, usually they spam ping out on the map.
Aether Lens for the Lion here.
But notice that Ehome are like playing very well around the combo that Secret has, the Sleep and the Ravage.
Yeah.
They're like taking very, you know, like two or three people around them at each time. And then after they commit a big ultimate like that, then they'll commit in with more. And now they have they don't have Ravage at file, only committed for solo Batrider kill. So they can actually fight this very easily with the Death Prophet ultimate. Unfortunately, they commit the finger to the last fight without a kill. But
that's right for the jacking.
Right for the jacking.
Right for the jacking.
There's not very many times with the right for the jacking, but this might be the right time here. Pilot Eye, though, is...
They're going to look to farm up, but Ravage is down. And they don't know that Ehome has vision because they place a sentry on it. But look how many sentries they committed to secure that stack. And now they feel safe, but it's not safe.
Envy's not safe here.
Envy
is...
Yeah, he's fine.
He's okay now.
Need to wait for nighttime.
Too soon for Roche, though, for Ehome.
Yes. I mean, Well, I mean, if they want to commit ghosts to it, but I think you only commit ghosts to it during daytime, which is... Yeah.
Okay, but...
They have darkness, and it's like 2 minutes until...
All the while, though, you know, it's still that ravage down. Ehome are taking...
It's right for the attacking, dude.
They're farming the secret jungle, too, so the secret only have the stack to farm into some of the lanes.
They're gonna punish us so hard.
Let's see. They see it happening here. What is the plan from Ehome?
They're gonna smoke and crush
Spark
them.
Is gonna try to maybe flank. Is he sweeping all the way down the low ground? But look at the rest of Ehome.
Oh, no smoke.
They're gonna see it come. They're pinging it. Misery, what is he gonna do about it?
They don't have Ravage. Are they just gonna leech experience? What is happening?
He's like baiting him. Like, I'm just a lion.
I don't know. Look at a lot of
these. He's just like, I'm just gonna farm down here in the lane while you guys are up there. Look at this. They're gonna come all the way behind. They're trying to reposition themselves so they can come from all fronts, maybe? But Secret are doing a good job. They're in reserve. They see the darkness. They're pulling their head back into the turtle shell.
If they wait too long, whatever's gonna be up.
They might just have to sap stack. They got what they could from it, but I don't know if this is gonna be the time to fight, especially if Ravage is still not gonna be ready for
this. They have ghosts. If they can wrap around with ghosts.
I think they just have to sack it.
Oh, they didn't even jack it? That's
they have to sack it, so Ehome are gonna jack it.
Okay.
Or nothing.
No harm, no foul.
Maybe they're like, we'll leave it. Maybe Secret will go before the food once more, and we'll try our trap again.
They don't have the ward down, though. I guess maybe they're waiting for, like, a Naga out of position, and then Lasso her, kill her, and then swoop in. Or else they just get slept and just run away.
Alright.
Okay.
I still have the vision of this happening here.
Yeah,
and...
but no time. It's just like, whatever. It's only the creeps left. Who cares?
Yeah. Okay, they'll see the remnant go down. Yeah, this now Naga's there who has Song. Don't even bother, Eleven. He's gonna take himself away to the top lane, it looks like. And Lady Death Prophet here, after picking up the Yules, already close to a BKB, straight to the BKB for her. And it looks like Dan has his first ulti orb already online, plus
you know
the chunk of money. Ah, get the hell out there! Brings him to the low ground. Away from his family and friends, and let's see if they can make it away. Puppy, if he really wanted to save him, could Song, and will commit the Song here. Is it all defensive, though? It looks like Pilot Out wants to heal up and engage. Misery, oh, goes right into a silence. There's going to be no Ravage for him. And Ehome are like, that sleeps on cooldown now. All right.
Baiting out of the ultimate, but let's see if they can actually make something happen with it this time. Death Prophet, very low on mana. Nighttime still.
Lasso cooldown a bit.
Long time.
But...
I saw that ward up there! Like, Secret... Yeah. Like, dead ward has been up the entire...
They figured it was, like, down here. It's like, I know that's a new ward spot, but... You know.
They've spent so long trying to farm that area and secure that area and take a good fight. And all of it has been nullified because of the ward.
There's, like, really not many other options to go to. Ehome have been taking residence in the secret jungle for so long, and you know there's a Shadowblink Slark in there, so... It's like shark in water, literally, so you don't want to go there at all. So all that's left is, like, a couple of lanes while they're pushed in, and that's it. And whoever farms that stack, which usually has to be done as a group effort. Gold's gonna be split apart. XP's gonna be split apart. Seeker are getting starved a little bit here in the mid-game. This Slark just, it feels like it has huge potential and is controlling the most of the map. And what helps controlling? Batriders. Darkness is coming out.
And BKB to counter the Sleep Ravage.
Yeah.
Need more BKBs though.
Ehome on pace to possibly make it yet another draw for them and another draw for Secret, but we'll see. Secret have
been farming like two camps every minute.
Yeah, it's not good. I mean, I've seen big comeback games on the back of a, you know, solo Ember Spear, Arteezy, Rapiers in hand, but this game he's not getting that kind of farm. Mid lane, poor little Pie gonna be taken away from his flank again this time.
Oh, he's fingered.
He's down.
Dang.
Yeah, the range is pretty damn ridiculous at that point. Oh my god, look at the items just flow in.
Woo!
Agnums all of a sudden here for the Night Stalker. BKB done.
Blink on Lion very soon.
Gem's gonna be coming next, and Secret are gonna be stuck in the dark. Like, this is going to be so tough. I mean...
Ward here!
Invoker, unfortunately, is not gonna be relevant. Hasn't really been too relevant at this point. They had a great synergy with the whole, like, Ensnare, Sunstrike combo in the early part, but didn't get enough from it. All right, let's see here as Secret are hungry for gold. Maybe taking tier ones if they can get that. committing in 5. They know they have the Ravage. Song probably back up by now. But Ehelm may be feeling confident that they still have the stronger 5 on 5. Especially with these new item pickups.
This Slark's
Axe.
So wussy.
He's standing in. You know, he's like, if I choke here, it's on me. Or maybe he's like, I want to get the Scotty first.
How do they kill him with his when he uses ultimate? I guess, like, maybe afterwards they can kill him, but they can just follow up with, like, Lion Stun, with Exorcism.
No Envy. Can they lock him down enough? Slight? Gone. No.
What a good timing for a Slight.
Yeah. I've seen that happen far too often for Ember Spirits. Being able to quick Remnant while they're midst a convenient Slight. All too well.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
But we just saw Envy escape, but can we see what he actually has? Okay, he's almost got, he has had the Battle Fury 3. No, not yet, actually. Still a component away, so.
Ooh, they have armor on. That'll be kind of evil. Oh, he gets gem.
Wow, yeah. What the
heck? What kind of spike was that?
That was like so the Sand King Bro strike there. It's pretty damn crazy. Radiant's bottom tower has fallen. All right, no Sunstrike this time yet. Kaka, as he's locked down, there's a bit of force coming out.
This is taking
he's still
way
running.
Too long.
Yeah, this is
Sleep run away.
That Agnum Scepter.
Where is this guy?
I'm farming, bro. Just chill out. Just you wait. Once I get my next item, that's when I'm gonna go.
Yeah.
Just you wait. Yeah, I agree. This is normally Slark is like, now I swallow up supports. I really become a nuisance, like a weasel. And
I feed off everything.
And he's like Eeyore now. He's like,
oh wait,
I gotta get farm. Playing like an AM almost.
He is not thirsty for kills.
Not at all. Well, we'll have to see when is going to be the right time for this, but hey, Seeker get a little something, and that precious stack is going to be worked on a bit more here. No 4-minute ward this time for Ehome to see what's going on. Envy, obviously, like, for every time he goes out to these side lanes, there is mild pressure. Even though they might be a swing and a miss, it's something that he's still going to have to continue to think about here.
They need a gem, Ehome. Maybe next night time, because he just got wrecked.
Alright, a couple promising pickups here for Secret. The Ag's now being grabbed up from Wii while Envy does finish that battle fee. Farm will come faster.
And the blink on Tide, that's a big deal.
Yes.
Because Ehom don't have good disengage. Secret have amazing disengage.
Alright, and
I think Ehom has given them too much time though. And they've, in their little ball, they've farmed their Secret shop camps very, very well. And they have like a Midas bots on the Invoker, and then they have like the Brufirium bots on Ember Spirit, so they can split push very well as the game progresses further and further.
I guess Ehome just waiting for the gem on Nightstalker, the extra item here for Death Prophet after a BKB, which seems to be a Shiva's.
They're waiting for 5 more items, Lord.
You know, it's gotta have everything in line.
He's an Abyssal. I don't know if he gets BKB now or Abyssal. But Abyssal's way better for... Oh, he gets BKB, okay. BKB's necessary versus their lineup, or else he'll die right after Shadow Dance because of the sleep. But Abyssal's way better the way he's playing, which is not fighting at all and just split pushing.
Here comes Secret now. As said, they got all those items at the ready. They're looking to put them to use. They're looking to get their hands dirty here.
Ooh,
but a smoke response... It was close. I didn't see a ping or anything from Secret.
I don't know if they were under the ward though. I think they were like one was to the left and one was to the right. Tiny.
But they pulled out as soon as it happened. So maybe they did.
Because darkness. So yeah. It's a more telltale sign.
Wow, so what are they making do here? They're going real deep here.
Ooh, not a good gem. Uh oh, somebody's about to get picked off.
He sees Invoker, he goes for the full misery, he's not going, oh no, misery! He's not going to be able to get the Ravage or the Blink off to go in, and it's a swing and a miss here, oh no, here comes Ehome now. They take on the Invoker, step
what's
back,
Blink.
I don't know, no Radiant
burn. Oh, he's going in.
And hey, suddenly Fan's in the game. He just got pie. What? Come on, that's not just a pie after all. Here two goes down, top lane pressure is coming in. But
bounce out there, I guess it's just Fan.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know.
Was it Firefly? I guess it was Firefly.
Maybe he
sometimes
touched
it's like
bit
hard
of fire.
To see on the ground.
Yeah. Oof. Well, that's a Ravage down. It's two heroes down. Damage. Some step back. Down they're not quick to the Roche yet. Kaka spotting it now. It's nighttime.
Clark, you could Roche so easily with your items.
I just need a little more time, Ben. Can you wait a minute? A little more time. We're talking level one Roche here. I gotta prepare.
Oh, Slart.
And there was a DD apparently,
something
too.
Else.
So.
Yeah, they're waiting so long. You can tell he's getting impatient.
Get in
I'm
there
getting...
and do it!
Oh, he's like, I'm fine.
Watching this guy.
Fine. You know, they lost game one. They're standing player. Wants to do his duty. Wants to make sure CTY comes back, you know. Hope he's doing well. I understand he's in the hospital right now. I'm
poor
sure
guy.
Why, but hopefully he does feel better and Ehon will be able to pull out a strong station wing and CT can make a wonderful story run.
Carry on his legacy, fam.
Carry it on. Sunstrike will scout things
panic.
Out. Fan is pleased to get it, though. And finally, they
I
will
I don't
bring
have enough
down.
Items to take this.
So I knew this was a bad idea. Well, he got the Aegis now, so he's safe to kind of wait a bit at his leisure. Early silence, but not going to stop the blink. That was the next pickup for Envy, the classic blink grab. That makes it feel a lot safer now. You know, just kind of leave an early remnant, blink forward, slight, makes himself out to safety. But doesn't add a lot offensively here, and look at these. Look, they're trying to cut him off here.
Oh, there's a tower here. Whoops.
Stands like I'm going for the tower. Either that or Envy will cross this way.
Oh, that's a gem. This could be...
Oh,
okay.
Oh.
I thought it was going to be a much good deal, but it actually was.
Yep, that was just a...
Oh, that could have been a big brawl. If VTP is in right here, they lose a gem.
Easy 100 gold.
100?
Oh, 75, right?
Yeah.
That's right. They got discounted.
Wait, what did... What did Batrider buy and sell?
Yeah, he's okay. Going for BKB. Yeah. He got his Batrider to a belt. It did feel like it slowed down a bit. I felt like he would have... Maybe almost even had the BKB by now, but it hasn't been most... It's not like last game where he's continually finding the picks. Envy and Secret are certainly not making it easy for him to get these kind of...
No,
Batrider
really
lasso
to that. That's strange.
So what do they got to do with it now? Move forward?
Well, they can pressure the high ground because they use Ghost on the one. And now they're forced to back, which wastes their Aegis.
Well, they'll get their tower. Here's Secret inside the high ground. Early Hex. Tornado. Nicely done from Wii. But they are going to get the lasso off, but it's quickly shaking off right now. And the bump forward here for Flame Break. They still continue to move in. Ravage right in the midst of it to try to slow them down, but the BKB is able to kind of force away the stun. Mizzer going for a TP. They don't have a way to stop him. It looks like Void not at the ready. And Lanham not able to make it in time. Only one takedown. It is on to Envy.
Still a good kill.
It's a good kill for Ehome. Only at the expense of what looks like a little, and a little BKB.
Wow, he's so slow with the Spirit Link and the couple sacks of Napalm. The Ember Spirit, he couldn't move at all.
Sticky. Right, boots of travel for Death Prophet now.
You don't want to use the Ace though if you're Ehome. Still have a good amount of time on it.
Yeah, they have enough time.
Man, so...
How much time? I mean, they have about 70 seconds, it looks like, for the next exorcism.
So 2.5.
But it's Fan.
Yeah, it is.
They gotta go,
dude,
but
it's fan.
So he's gonna, like, chill out for a while.
He's not dealing well with a split push either. Like, usually you're, like, deathly afraid of split push against a Slark, but not these guys. No, not this Slark.
He's definitely playing it very farm intensive here. 3k gold. Uh-oh, 11 on the prowl. Highlight Dime goes, gets a little viz. They're really curious.
Oh, hi guys. Hey, just let me use it.
You're
oh,
late,
wait.
Fan.
No, they have
jump that illusion.
Run!
Get out of there, Fan!
Run!
Oh, a little bit of body blockage. Yules is going to be there. And the pounce is a miss.
And that's...
Fan, back to the jungle. Just get back and keep farming. Maybe another item will help you out, my man.
Okay.
Fan. Just get back.
So much for Aegis number one.
Man, we gotta do something with this, right? Get this.
Why
down.
Was he scared? Why didn't he pop PKD there?
Yeah, they just, bro.
Dude, nerves, man. Land, stand in, come on.
Relax, you're doing
breathe.
Fine.
You know, he dropped game one.
You're supposed to feel like godly in this sort of situation as Slark. You're so farmed over everyone else. And you have the Aegis. And you have EKB.
But he is not. He's not imposing the will of fan on secret.
Yeah. He definitely was not this passive
in
the last game.
He needed a pistol, for sure. Well, that's because the team was like, okay, we're pushing now.
Yeah.
This game, he's given a lot more autonomy and using it to farm. Oh, hello. How do they stop the Blink Dagger, though?
Oh, like that. Quick draw, McGraw coming out here from 11. Pulls him right back into trouble. Right into a silence. I don't think they have the manpower to take him down. Another silence, man. A lot of hate to stop him. Is it still going to be enough? It will be. Whew. It was like a mini ballet right there. That was nice. Uh-oh. On the other side, death ward committed here from Mr. Pie as he goes under the Shadow Amulet.
Stand in there!
And somewhere fighting right now, but Lanham's the one in trouble. Weehaw, the magician, not going to be able to catch him. A good blink away. He's gone.
Oh, well, that's too much fight for me.
He's like, whoa, is that an ice wall?
I'm out here, bro.
I got something. I did something. I'm good enough. I'm out here. I got my later. 10 minutes, maybe. Oh!
What?
Gotta applaud. That was close.
Oh, they saw him with Forge.
Hey, ghosts are out this time for the high ground push, knowing that Envy is still going to be out in 30 seconds.
Oh, he's not beating on the tower yet.
He's Sam's like, whoa, wait for me. We're pushing.
Push or... me and Texby's good. Okay.
Yeah, SMY wasn't good enough last time. Oh, 11 forced in. Looking to step away, has the BKB up and snared him up, but not enough damage to finish him off. And as Puppy will dish out the song here, 11 will be able to make it back to the low ground.
They oh, he has
quick fuels. Does he have a ramp? He's trying to get a Ravage off, it looks like. Sunstrike will hit, but not the biggest of damage.
Where's
and,
Fan?
Ehome will leave.
Where's Fan?
Fan's in there.
He's not in there.
I mean, he's
That's
in there.
The whole point.
He's in with his team. He's not getting up in there. He's just there.
Well, maybe he has taken after CCY with the Moonshard.
Can he kidnap that guy? Oh, 11 has lasso here.
Kidnap.
I'm out that door, I'm gonna get you! Again, a quick pullback. The Yule can be there, slows him down, but
dead.
Not
close up. Pick up the gem.
I'm down. Now I did the song anyways, but as they go in and break out the fight, Misery commits his Ravage. He ends up going down as well.
Fans in!
Naga with the buyback. Wait, no. Naga gets her jet back, it looks like.
How do they not get them out of that? Oh, okay.
Good ice wall, maybe. It seems like they couldn't walk past it to get to the gem. And
Fans just scared.
A good Ravage from Mizrak slowed them down a bit.
Just eat the moon shard and take that thing.
Dude, this guy's so scared. It's okay. He hasn't died.
Yeah.
And he's gotten a lot of farm.
Yeah. I mean, he's top of the net worth still.
I wonder why.
Yeah. His hands are pretty clean, but they're dirty from farm.
Oh, that soil.
Mmm.
Mmm.
Well,
Puppy bought back just to get that friggin' gem.
Yeah, you know? He didn't have a song. It's not like he bought back to have a song set up or anything. It was all for the gem. And
it's that important. This
sustains. Do they? I mean, they still have a gem on Ehome, so.
Yeah, but you want to take that away from the Naga, because the Naga illusion can scout out the Slark when he's trying to gank. If he's trying to gank, they could scout him out.
Yes. You know what? Maybe Fan's ahead of the game, and he's like, I don't even need to gank because they have a gem, guys. Like,
yeah,
I'm only going to put myself
in split push and farm and get a ton of gold.
Well, at least I'm not dying. Oh! BKB will keep the Death Prophet alive here. Valiant effort, though, from Weehaw. Gets her PM low and forces, of course, out the BKB, so. Okay. Something.
Deward that. Nice.
Okay, Fan, this is your chance
to go
somewhere else. While Lanham's like, Fan, up here, fool! They are going to move in now. They're going to get the pounce of the finger and.
Up here, fool!
That was much more on Lanham, but hey, Fan was there to get off the pounce and some right clicks, so.
He scouted out where he wasn't.
He's like, maybe you want to see if there was backup nearby, so. There you go, Fan.
He thought there was an ice wall there.
He's like, I want to make sure there's no hidden witch doctor.
What item did he get? Basher? I saw an item.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Whew. Good job. Yeah.
Bash those creeps. Bash their head in.
Alright, now Secret, as they advance to the top lane, we
Wait,
see
Fan doesn't have a TP though. How is he gonna get through this fight?
He's not. He's got a bounty rune down there he's gonna probably go for and just farm that bit. Scout it out for the illusion, but look at this top. They make another move for Death Prophet here, but he's moving in. Yule. Ravage out. And a lot of ults. They got the Yules. Ehome's on route from behind, but it's taking too long. Now Death Prophet goes down, but they're gonna fight here. There you go. You just wasted all of those magical spells, so we're gonna go ahead and take you apart here. Meow tries to TP, but it quickly hexed up. And here comes the Batrider. 11's gonna be moving and taking flight. They finish off Wii. They scout out Lil Pi. They take down. And all three go down and
Fan almost gets there.
And you Fan's like, good job, guys. Nice work. Boom, got that creep. Look at that creep die. Get that creep.
Bash those creeps.
Do you guys like my basher? Bashing these creeps. See more of me on VG Potential.
You got this, man.
Nonetheless, a good retort, if you will, from Ehome. Death Prophet really made them work for them. All those spells lingered with the U a bit and allowed Ehome to get their own bit of response time.
Oh, Fan's up in their business. Come on, come for Roche number
nope.
two, Fan.
He saw an illusion.
We need you for Roche, Fan.
He saw an illusion. He's got to go.
Fan, we need you. We're at Roche right now. But we don't have any damage.
Wait, who is at the Roche right now?
We are Roche. Yeah, they are. Dude, they're at Roche. They're doing it without him.
Hello? Fan, get over there.
Oh,
he's like, guys,
guy
guys,
oh, he
Envy's
a
here. Oh. Get over there. No, it's maybe in a day they'll
finish
this
doing
one.
Roche without.
Well, Fan's like, guys, if I'm in the lane and they see me, they'll never think you're doing Roche. I'm helping out. Show himself.
They have wards.
There's like, there's guys, no they way they'll do a Roche if Slark is farming.
Give me the Aegis.
All right, well, it's pretty obvious now. Batrider just starts flying that way from the mid lane a bit.
Okay, do they give Old Chicken the Aegis or did they give Slark the Aegis? I'm saying Old Chicken.
Based on gameplay, yes, Old Chicken will probably put it to more use, but maybe Fan gets the Aegis and he's like, now I got this extra life. It didn't last time matter, but maybe he's like, now I can feel a bit more rambunctious. He might still pop his BKB first, but we'll see. Maybe this will be the tool he needed to be a bit more adventurous and really take it to Secret while he's got such a ridiculously good advantage. Looks like they caught out Puppy here.
Oh wait, Fan can't get there.
Yules, silence. Old Chicken don't need no Fan. Oh, gets the song off here. Maybe he does need a Fan. Oh, Lanham. Fortunately, he could have. I think even with his nice Aether lens, it would have been a bit too far to try to do it from the outside of that song. Misery will make it away as well. And
dude, Fan, you're six slotted right now.
If you count that Aegis. But he can still get a courier and load that thing up, so we got time.
He can still get BOTs.
He can still get BOTs, he can still
get a butterfly.
He has to get something to replace the
oh,
shoes.
Oh, this is a rapier Aegis. Time actually for Envy. I think he's been dying a lot though.
Ugh. He's done it for at Frankfurt.
Yeah, but not against a Nightstalker and Axe. Right, he's died, what, four times?
This is very three, scary, yeah. Blinking Lions, you know,
since
Agnum's Stalker, a Blinking Batrider. You gotta be scared for your life if you're Envy in this game. You gotta be able to read the game so well to know what lane is safe to farm and win. Especially if Ehome are ever off the radar, any of them. Ooh. A Refresher for Batrider. Alright.
He does not have the Maniple for that, though.
He got equals too. Well, he gets no one has arcanes on his team either, huh? Yeah, he definitely does have the mana. Even Lanham has boots of travel. That's cool.
Need that bounty rune. Hey guys, let's use the Aegis.
He's like almost ready.
Slark, come mid. We need you right now. Come on, bro. 3 minutes on Aegis. Don't
He's like,
be scared.
But is Roche almost up? He's like, you have the Aegis. Come.
Can I get a second Aegis? Do we have cheese, guys?
Someone with a cheese be ready behind me, please. Alright, Octarine Core.
But my BKB's not 10 seconds anymore.
Didn't one of your friends call it an Octane Core?
Yeah.
High Octane Core here for the Death Prophet. And with a tier 3 already down, Rax is now exposed. This is Ehome looking to take this series to a draw and claim their one
Man,
point.
Kill the ward!
What else got it? It's okay, fan. Back to the Drax. Oh, he had a tornado here. He's got a BKB. This is good. He's got a Roshan. Get the hell out of there. Whose ghosts are those? Oh, those are my ghosts. Let's go back in. In they go.
Oh, wait.
Secret. Very
I'm not
passive.
Supposed to stand next to creeps.
Watch out for the meatball. Pounces away from trouble. Waits it out. Goes back in. Both Raxes are going to be down. E-Home do their first serious based advancement
Ooh,
in.
Creeps.
And E-Home are gone, just like that. Secret obviously knowing that they would have to bow out.
Did he have all the ring before that? What's the cooldown on this?
Yeah.
Okay. So they have 1 minute with Exorcism and the Aegis next. Oh,
man! Man, this is very unlike you, fan. Are you seriously going for a solo pick? I don't know if to be surprised or proud. Not enough to get the job done, and 11's like, I'll pick up the pieces, but unfortunately, almost, yeah, he gets caught into a tornado himself, has the BKB, and he's like, Fan, where were you? Fan's back now, drops the Abyssal, it is going to be to a song, but he's got that BKB, and he's not going to be able to get the finish on the Wii. He's got to get out of there. It's like, I knew it, I can't go in there and fight. I got to get out of here. And he is gone. What was 11 doing? He's like, you're not going to finish him, I will, and he just like dove into the base, trying to get one.
He almost had a lasso and pulled him downhill, which Fan could have finished off with his BKB, but he didn't get the lasso off. And Fan, I don't think, provided a vision up the hill, which is very desperately needed. So now I don't, like, what's the timer on Aegis? 30-ish
seconds?
It's
gone. It's going to be gone at any moment. They're not going to be able to do anything with it.
Well, leaves time for Span to get one more item.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And then the next Aegis and the possible next go. We'll see. Maybe the Octarine Core is enough to get E-Home excited about pushing again without needing an Aegis. We'll see.
You mean Fan. E-Home's been very excited to push.
Yeah. I don't know how persuasive. Maybe Lanham's like, I haven't really been with this guy. I'd be hard on my team, but I don't want to yell at him too much. Refresher, now complete.
Levin's tired. I'm tired of this nonsense. He wants to lasso people nonstop.
I gotta tell you, Levin's Batrider's pretty damn nice.
Yep.
This series.
He needs some mana, though.
Mm. Ooh. Try to get bot.
Pie so far in the back.
He's got the Aegis. Get up there and siege.
He does not have the Aegis.
Oh, not anymore. Yeah. Oh, Envy is going for Apier here.
Yeah, that's doing this sort of situation.
Well, Tears for Trouble. Eat takedown with the help of this mighty exorcism. Now they're going for the next
Don't
Rax.
Be scared, fan.
He's like, I'm in it. I'm going. Let's see. What's Secret going to do? They're going to get Pie caught. And this could be the end of their Death Ward. Unless he has a buyback. He's out. No buyback. Song already used. It's not for a setup here. Secret have to make do with what they got, and it could be a Ravage follow-up Invoker combo. Here it is. There's the big Ravage, and it'd be enough to take down Lanham. He quickly buys back. He's got Boots of Travel. He's looking to come in and end this game out. There is the secondary lasso grab onto the mighty Weehaw. We'll pull right back into the action. The Yule's going to throw him up. Where's Fana? He's going in. He gets a nice Abyssal lockdown onto Invoker.
That's
he is
rapier.
Going to be out. Is this it here? It's rapier in hand. Can Envy do it? Oh, big damage through with the Slide of Fist is going to be forcing Kaka back, but Van.
Van's going in!
He's going in. He's got Misery down. And they're looking to walk away.
Envy. Oh, he has to be careful. He can get hacked.
Oh, we got hacked up. Did he not know Lana bought back? I don't know, but he got caught out, taken down. That's a raid on the deck, and that could
Van.
Just be the game.
Van
has done it.
Yeah, Van! Woo!
E-Home have done it. 30-17 is going to be your closeout score here, and they're going to be drawing this series up 1-1.
You know,
both of these.
That's
teams.
A nice clean game from them, though. That was a very
safe.
They just had great map control all game, though, because of the Sark Shadowblade, because of the Blink Batrider, and the Night Stalker Ags.
I mean,